Prime Minister of India and
Nalesh Babu.
Secular great leader, the former Prime Minister of India and Rajya Sabha MP Sri H.D. Devagowda ji, and my another leader and Union Minister Sri H.D. Kumar Swami ji, and I also extend my gratitude to the people of my constituency Kolar and people of Karnataka for entrusting me with this responsibility. I want to extend my heartfelt thanks to Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji and Honorable Finance Minister Srimati Nirmala Sitaraman ji, who has presented a good Union Budget 24-25. In the history of Indian democracy, our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji has been elected for the third consecutive term, and NDA government is presenting the budget for a record 11 years continuously, promising a true and wide vision on key fields that emphasizes the development of the nation and ample opportunities for all. Speaker sir, the budget has focused on skill development to reap benefits out of demographic dividends, where the youth, both men and women, will improve their skills and take advantage of abundant opportunities in the field of employment and entrepreneurship. The government has taken up steps to skill 20 lakh youths over 5 years, including women. Importance is given to women, which is almost 50% of our population, by reserving 3 lakh crores for women-led development schemes for their economic development. Importance is also given for working women hostels. The government has also opened new opportunities in higher studies by giving financial support of up to 10 lakhs in domestic institutions. Projecting the MSME to compete globally would make the nation footprint in manufacturing and services industries and another important priority. Providing MSMEs with guarantee, enhancing Mudra loan limit to 20 lakhs from 10 lakhs will make the young entrepreneurs to establish on their own. A scheme to provide internship in top 500 companies to 1 crore youths in 5 years by giving rupees 5,000 internship per month, which will create employment to youth. The government has taken responsibility by sanctioning 3 crore houses in rural areas, which will bring down the economic burden to the people who come under below poverty line. The government has planned for constructing 1 crore houses in urban 2.0 scheme by allocating 10 lakh crores. The government has given importance to agriculture sector in the
fields. एक सेकंड प्लीज, एक मिनट. मैं सदन से आग्रह करता हूं कि माननीय सदस्य बोलने तक का समय बढ़ा दें, और माननीय मंत्री जी से आग्रह करूंगा कि जो बोलने वाले वक्ता हैं उनको कहे वो सदन में बैठे, जिनको आगे बोलना है. बोलने वाले वक्ता नहीं बैठे हैं सदन में, उनको बोला आगे से बैठे हैं. यहाँ पर जो कल बोलने वाले आज बोलने वाले थे वो भी सदन में बैठे, यहाँ पे लिस्ट में जिनका नाम है. हाँ, सदन में बैठेंगे तो सुनेंगे तो बोलेंगे.
The government has given importance to agriculture.
और कोई भी माननीय सदस्य बोलकर सीधा चला जाएगा तो उसको बोलने का नंबर नहीं दिया जाएगा. सदन में आपकी सलाह मानता हूं, लेकिन ये आसन का अधिकार है कि ऐसे माननीय सदस्य बोलते हैं और सदन से चले जाते हैं. ऑनरेबल,
द गवर्नमेंट हैज गिवन इंपॉर्टेंस टू एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर इन द फील्ड्स ऑफ रिसर्च टू प्रोवाइड क्लाइमेट रेजिलिएंट वैराइटीज, व्हिच इज अटमोस्ट रिक्वायर्ड ड्यू टू क्लाइमेट चेंज. इट इज ऑल्सो गिविंग थ्रस्ट टू नेचुरल फार्मिंग एंड डिजिटल पब्लिक इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर for coverage of farmers and their land. The government has adopted PM Surya Ghar Muft Yojana, where solar units are installed on rooftops to obtain free electricity to 1 crore households. This will reduce the burden on power sector, and economically the householder will benefit. The schemes and allocation that the government of India has announced under innovation, research and development and next generation reforms would rather attract and support the new way thinking and exploitation of themselves in good manner for establishment of Viksit Bharat, which is utmost result of this budget 24-25. Government is giving priorities to youth, women, agriculture, housing, tourism and entrepreneurship development. So India is surely going to become the third biggest economy in the near future. I also wish to emphasize the importance of key issues relevant to my parliamentary constituency Kolar, like water and drinking and irrigation purpose to Kolar and Chikpalapur districts from Krishna River, food processing units for tomato and mango at Kolar, Srinivaspur and Mulbagal, a government medical college and a multi-speciality hospital, railway coach factory which was proposed in 2016, retirement benefits of Bharat Gold Mines Limited employees issue pending since 2001, regularization of BEML contract employees at KJF unit, upgradation of state highways to national highway from Hoskote to Madanpally, B. Kotkota to Hosur, Kuppam to Bagepalli. Thank you, Honorable Speaker, for giving me an opportunity in this August House. Jai Hind.